Floral waters can often be diluted with additives such as alcohol, aloe vera, or glycerin, and can sometimes contain preservatives or synthetic fragrances. This homemade chamomile hydrosol contains just one naked ingredient, chamomile flowers. A hydrosol is made of plant components, traces of essential oil, and water. They are wonderfully aromatic, meaning they have a strong scent, and are a more gentle version of the therapeutic properties found in essential oils. Since they are water-based, there's no need to dilute them. You can make a hydrosol at home with dried or fresh herbs, and can even combine different herbs and flowers together to create unique blends. When making hydrosols at home, a good rule of thumb is to double the amount of herbs needed when using dried herbs. For example, use 3 cups of fresh herbs or 6 cups of dried herbs to make the hydrosol. Chamomile water can be used to help relieve hot or irritated skin, to help clean or soothe minor cuts, scrapes, burns, or wounds. It can help soothe itching or burning eyes, or it can be used to help relieve symptoms of nappy rash. To make this homemade chamomile hydrosol, begin by placing a heat-resistant bowl or glass jar in the center of a large saucepan or stockpot. The jar acts as a container to catch the condensing steam that will become the chamomile water. Next, arrange the chamomile flowers around the jar, then add just enough water to cover the flowers in the saucepan, avoiding the glass jar. The jar needs to stay above the water and flowers so it can catch the floral water as it condenses. Place the lid on top, but sit it upside down, and place the pan on medium-low heat and bring the water to a simmer. Add 2-4 cups of ice on top of the inverted lid and let the water simmer for 20-25 minutes, adding more ice to the top of the lid as it melts. After simmering, carefully remove the lid, pouring the ice water into the sink. Using oven mitts, lift the glass jar of floral water out of the saucepan or stock pot and pour the water into a clean glass bottle or amber dropper bottle using a funnel. Then it's ready to use. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. Let me know if you tried this recipe yourself and if you've used any floral hydrosols before. I'd love to know and I'd love to hear your thoughts on them. I hope you have a wonderful day and I'll see you soon again.